Who doesn't love summer? It's a time for backyard barbecues, cookouts, pool parties, and great food. But if you want to stay happy, healthy, and comfortable, there are a few summertime favorites you ought to keep away from. Nothing goes down on a hot summer afternoon quite like an ice-cold margarita. But there's a catch to this cocktail, and it can be quite a serious one too. If you're fixing yourself a drink and manage to splash some of that lime juice on your skin, there's a strong possibility it's going to react in the sunlight, causing rashes and potentially even a second-degree burn. If your skin is wet or sweaty, it's going to make the reaction even worse. While some people might not even realize there's anything wrong, others can develop open sores that require serious medical attention.
It can range from mild rash to significant blistering all over the skin.
This condition is so commonly associated with summertime drinks that it's actually known as margarita burn. But the official name for it is phytophotodermatitis. It happens because lime and other citrus fruits contain a chemical called furocoumarin, which is activated by UV rays. There are also a few other summertime food favorites that can make you more sensitive to the sun's effects, including dill, fennel, celery, figs, and parsley. Obviously, they're not going to be quite so common at your pool party as a jug of margaritas, but it's worth knowing nonetheless. Everyone knows that old cliché, avoid the potato salad at a backyard barbecue, because that unrefrigerated mayo is likely to make you sick. But that's actually not what's going on here, and it's not why you should avoid the potato salad after all. Mayo, as it turns out, has enough acid in it to keep it pretty safe out of the fridge. Store-bought mayo is made that way on purpose, with enough acidic contents to kill pathogens and reduce the potential for spoiling. The problem is that you're adding a ton of other ingredients to the potato salad that have a relatively low acidity, like the potatoes themselves. That's actually what acts to create a breeding ground for bacteria. And the most common kind of bacteria that's found growing on potato salad comes from people. Staphylococcus aureus is one of the frequent offenders, and that's often transferred to the salad from people's faces. Add in the likelihood that potato salad isn't being kept at a safe temperature of below 41 degrees Fahrenheit, and you've got the recipe for a bacterial playground. Deviled eggs are a great little finger food for parties, but if you happen to be at a cookout and see a tray sitting out with eggs for the taking, you might want to rethink this one. Salmonella is the biggest danger when it comes to deviled or hard-boiled eggs. It can basically live anywhere in or on the egg, and it's impossible to tell what's contaminated and what's not. An egg that's covered with salmonella won't look or smell any different. But it will leave you with a fever, cramps, and painful gastrointestinal distress, with the most extreme cases requiring hospitalization. And yes, there's a chance it can be deadly, too.
I was dying earlier today, and then I died. Now I'm dead.
The danger only increases in the summer, particularly because of the high temperatures. When eggs are kept at 40 degrees Fahrenheit or above, that makes it even more likely salmonella is going to multiply. And even if you buy your eggs already hard-boiled, there's still a chance of food poisoning. In 2019, The Hill reported on a listeria outbreak that had killed at least one person and sickened others, which was traced back to commercially produced hard-boiled eggs. Bottom line, make your deviled eggs at home and keep them in the fridge. Tomatoes taste great, and they're good for you too, so what could possibly go wrong? Well, a lot apparently. Research by the University of Minnesota's Center for Infectious Disease Research and Policy found that between 1990 and 2007, raw tomatoes had caused more than 79,000 cases of food poisoning. Outbreaks were linked to whole and cut tomatoes, and they say that the culprit is usually salmonella. Investigation by food safety authorities in some of the outbreaks found contamination at the source, in irrigation pond water. When they're sliced without being properly cleaned, bacteria can be transferred to the inside of the tomatoes, which just happens to be almost perfect for the bacteria to multiply. And that's also the reason you shouldn't buy damaged tomatoes. The contamination can very easily grow throughout. Given that raw tomatoes so frequently show up in things like salads and on burgers, it's no wonder they're linked to so many cases of food poisoning. Corn has something of a reputation as one of the least healthy vegetables out there, but that's not particularly warranted. It's high in fiber, vitamins, and minerals, and it's low in fat, too. Corn is also high in starch, which can impact your blood sugar levels. But overall, it's pretty good stuff. But you should still keep away at your next barbecue. This is because corn on the cob is regularly featured on dentist lists of foods to avoid. If you have fillings or sealants, you're running the risk of loosening or cracking them. Anyone with orthodontics, like braces, can definitely do some terrible damage too. And if you have dentures, you're likely to have even more trouble with corn on the cob. Even if you don't permanently damage any dental aids you might have, you're still going to need to brush and floss after eating corn if you want to stay healthy. And let's be honest, nobody's bringing floss to a party. Best play it safe here and avoid corn on the cob altogether. Not everyone is going to be keen on the idea of slurping down an oyster, especially on a hot summer's day. But even if you are, you ought to think twice about it. Raw oysters might not just ruin your afternoon, they might scupper your entire summer. That's because raw oysters and other types of shellfish are linked to an illness called vibriosis. And it's not uncommon either. Around 80,000 people get it every year, and it's nasty stuff. Symptoms range from mild gastrointestinal distress to infections in the bloodstream, skin lesions, and sometimes limb amputation becomes necessary.
We would recommend, you know, to be cautious about eating raw oysters at any time, not just the summertime.
Proper cooking will get rid of contamination, but raw oysters should be a serious no-go, especially if you're eating them between May and October. The warmer water temperatures present during these months increases the likelihood that the naturally occurring bacteria will be present in the waters the oysters come from. Because they feed by constantly cycling water through their shells, this means that oysters can easily build up a high and potentially dangerous concentration of that bacteria. Here's some bad news for meat lovers. Research has shown that all those super-seared steaks on the grill that you love so much absolutely don't love you back. In 2010, a study from Vanderbilt University found that regular consumption of well-done meat increases a person's intake of something called heterocyclic aromatic amines. There's more bad news, too. Meat cooked over a grill also contains another type of chemical called polyacyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, or PAHs. PAHs form when all the juices and fats drip out of meat and land directly onto a fire, which is exactly what happens when you're grilling. Both of those chemicals are metabolized by the enzymes present in our bodies, but the byproducts of that process have been linked to both cancer and damage to human DNA. While researchers stress that every person's unique genetic makeup means that these byproducts are going to affect them differently, just how well do you know your DNA? It might be better to be safe than sorry on this one. When Time magazine asked a panel of experts whether or not a hot dog was a good choice of food in basically any scenario, the answer was an overwhelming no. There are a few reasons why. Hot dogs are about as highly processed as you can get, and processed meats have been linked with an increased risk for type 2 diabetes. You've also got to factor in the inevitably high nitrate content of hot dogs. It doesn't matter where nitrates come from. Our bodies still turn them into nitrites, and those are linked to an increased risk of various cancers. What about hot dogs that advertise themselves as being without added nitrites? Well, Oscar Mayer might say they're healthier, but researchers from the World Health Organization have been less quick to make that kind of claim. If you're still not sure about hot dogs, here's a fun little bit of trivia. When the Dream and Nightmare Laboratory of Montreal conducted a study to see if foods really do impact the quality of your sleep and the content of your dreams, they found that 12.5% of study participants named hot dogs as serious nightmare fuel. Who would have thought? If you're looking for a quick way to cool down without worrying about ingesting too much fat or too many calories, you might opt for a snow cone or some shaved ice. But experts say these options aren't much better than other desserts, and you might be surprised as to why. Dentists from Pediatric Dental Care say that shaved ice and snow cones can refreeze and subsequently hide massive chunks of ice, which can lead to a broken or chipped tooth. Beyond that, however, there's the sugar content. The American Heart Association says that women should limit their added sugar intake to less than 25 grams per day, and men should limit theirs to 36 grams. But Livestrong says that snow cone syrup is going to put a serious dent in your daily limits. 2 ounces of syrup contains a massive 18 grams of sugar. And to be honest, you're going to want to get more than just one flavor, right? Obviously, summer is summer, and nobody's going to hold it against you if you want to indulge yourself with a sweet treat or two. Just don't go thinking snow cones are any healthier than the rest. Half the fun of many cookout foods are the toppings, but there's one topping that you'll definitely want to skip. Sprouts might be incredibly good for you, but they're also really, really good at carrying bacteria. Sprouts have been linked with dozens of food poisoning outbreaks, sickening thousands of people. And this isn't just one kind of sprouts either, it's all of them. That means alfalfa, clover, mung beans, and basically any other kind you can think of are all potentially dangerous, and any of them can contain salmonella or listeria. The problem is how they're grown. Sprouts sprout when they're kept in a warm, humid place, which is precisely the same kind of environment that bacteria thrives in. If seeds have bacteria on them when they're harvested, that bacteria can stay there for months while the seeds stay dormant. Then, seeds sprout, bacteria multiplies, and they're subsequently eaten by people who probably think they're taking the healthy choice. Food waste is a huge problem, and no one likes to see perfectly good leftovers go in the garbage. But if you're at your neighbor's for a cookout and they're nice enough to package up some leftover goodies for you, you might want to pass up on them. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the window of time for leaving food out in the summertime and having it still safe to eat is very short. If it's over 90 degrees Fahrenheit, it's just 1 hour. If it's cooler, food should still only be outside of the fridge for 2 hours. Otherwise, bacteria is going to multiply incredibly quickly. But there's something else to consider, too. How is the food prepped? If you're at a campground or state park, for example, keeping everything clean and sanitary can be tough. Even food you might not suspect could be susceptible to cross-contamination. In some cases, you might just want to toss it instead of risking your health. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more MASH videos about your favorite foods are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.